Have you ever had any addictions that you had to overcome?
No. And it's not because I'm not addicted to dark chocolate. It's because I've never had to overcome that addiction to dark chocolate.
This is my secret life.
This is my secret life.
This is my secret life.
When I was starting grad school, I was really interested in the mind-body connection. Your brain controls everything in your body, and so it seemed that we'd be able to harness that power. So what I study is the interaction between the environment and a drug. Whenever you use a drug in a certain environment, your body learns to associate that environment with the drug. For example, in Vietnam War, there was a very high number of people who were addicted to opiate drugs. But when those veterans came back to the United States, 98% managed to stay clean, which was completely unheard of in the field of opiate research. Their bodies are still detoxing, but they left all of their conditioned cues aside, and that probably helped them stay clean. Heroin addiction is really tenacious. The most conservative estimate is 86% relapse. And so if we could even find a tiny little modification that would make a dent in that relapse rate, then we could probably help a lot of people.
I think it's time for a costume change.
Okay. The rule of the brain is you are who you talk to. And so I started doing stunts and circus stuff because I started hanging out with those people. People who were fire spinners and bullwhip experts and swordsmen. It was just seeing people who were doing cool things and say, show me that, I've gotta learn how to do that. I really liked circus things, Chinese pole, aerial tissue, weapons work, martial arts, fights and things. I'd always been athletic, but I never really thought of using that in stunts. A lot of women don't think of using that as stunts. We don't even think of that as one of the possible career options for an athletic person. Mostly what I've done are stage fights, tightrope walking and things. I think the most intense thing I've had to do was to be a double-bullwhip wielding villainess named Snakeskin on a Nickelodeon show called Supah Ninjas. I had to wield these bullwhips, and each end of the bullwhip had a snake head on it that would digitally be altered to bite the person when I actually, as if the whip didn't hurt enough. Stunts and neuroscience seem like totally different areas, and they are actually very different. I like that I can kind of just turn that neuroscience off and just go and play. Being in these two different worlds, I've really tried to keep them separate because I was afraid that neither would take me seriously if they knew about the other. However, at some point on Supah Ninjas, they asked me, you know, why haven't you been on set for a couple years? What's going on? Were you injured or something? And I said, no, to be honest, I was finishing my PhD and doing a postdoc. And from that point on, they called me Doc on set, which was kind of fun. You know, I'd be all ready to go and camera speeding and I've got two bullwhips in my hand and they're like, go Doc and action. That was fun.